Hi everyone, in this video we will multiply and divide numbers using logarithmic tables. Let's solve these three problems using logarithmic tables. Here's a problem where we have both multiplication and division together. Now what we'll do? We'll use the same log property. First take log on both sides, so you get log x is equal to this much. Assume that this is equal to x. So take log on both sides, you get log x is equal to this much. This is nothing but log a into b by c. This is of this form, right? So you can write this as log a plus log b minus log c, right? If you have division, it becomes minus. If you have multiplication, it becomes addition. Division becomes subtraction, right? So you get this. Now separately find log of this, this, this. So let's do the simple calculations of the log values and we will get log x. X will become anti-log of this. Find the anti-log, you'll get 11.36. So this is the x value. Now let's take this example. Here you have all 0.00, right? That means the clue is you're going to get negative values here now, right? Because there is 0.00, 0.00. So you're going to get negative values now. So when you find the log value, you're going to get negative characteristic, right? So obviously, say you have 0.07 here. Where is the non-zero number? It's in second place, right? So what is the characteristic? It will be 2 and it's going to be minus 2 because this number is less than 1. So minus 2. So minus 2. And here in this case, where is the non-zero number? Third place. Third place. So it's going to be minus 3. Minus because it's less than 1. So minus 3. So minus 3 here. Right? Here also. Here, where is the non-zero number? After the decimal point, first 1. So minus 1. Right, like this we have all negative values here now, right? So when you have negative values, you will have to split. This will become minus 1, this will become 7543, minus 2, 8971, 863, minus 3. So split all of this, right? And then you add and subtract, do the simple calculation, you will get this one, right? Now you find the anti-log, right? This is log x, so x will be anti-log of this much. Find the anti-log. So you get anti-log as 4989, put the decimal point 4.991 into 10 to the power 1 because we have 1 here. So you get 49.91. Let's take this particular example. You have square root here. You have 3 by 2 also as a power. So square root you can write it as 6.43 to the power half. And 13.46 to the power 3 by 2 you can write as 3 by 2 into log of 13.46, right? This will be half into log of 6.43, right? Now you split this like this. So this multiplication will become addition, division will become subtraction using the log properties, log theorems, right? Now you find the log value. Here you're getting all negative values. When you calculate all of this, you split here again. Don't forget to split. Split. Since you have minus as the characteristic, split it here, right? Otherwise, you don't have to split. Since the only places where there is minus, you split it, right? And then do the calculation. So you get this as a calculation. See, you got negative value here. You got negative value here, right? Since it's negative value, now we will have to do the plus and minus case. When you have a negative value, do plus and minus. What is, we need to add one more than this. We have 1 here. One more than that is 2. Plus 2, minus 2 you add with this number. So you take plus 2. Subtract with this number, 2 minus this and minus 2, right? 2 minus 1.5 will give you 0.547 and then you have this minus 2, right? Then you have this minus 2. So this minus 2 will become the characteristic. Minus 2 is characteristic and 4732 is the mantissa, right? Now you can find the anti-log of this. So we'll find anti-log of 4732. 4732 anti-log is 2973. 2973, you put decimal point after first digit into 10 to the power minus 2 because you have minus 2 as a characteristic. So that's all. Then left shift by 2 decimal points. Left shift. 1. This is 1. Second. And here the decimal point. Right? So this is the x value. So with this, we have come to the end of this particular video and this particular topic. Thanks for watching. Hope this video was useful.